This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Territories of the United States are sub-national administrative divisions directly overseen by the United States federal government, unlike U.S. states, which share sovereignty with the federal government. These territories are classified by whether they are incorporated part of the United States proper and whether they have an organized government through an organic act passed by the U.S. Congress. Currently, the United States has 16 territories, 5 of which are permanently inhabited: Puerto Rico, Guam, Northern Mariana Islands, the U.S. Virgin Islands, and American Samoa. They are classified as unincorporated territories. They are organized, self-governing territories with locally elected governors and territorial legislatures. Each also elects a non-voting member or resident commissioner to the U.S. House of Representatives. 11 territories are small islands, atolls and reefs, spread across the Caribbean and Pacific, with no native or permanent populations. These are Palmyra Atoll, Baker Island, Howland Island, Jarvis Island, Johnston Atoll, Kingman Reef, Midway Islands, Bajo Nuevo Bank, Navassa Island, Serenia Bank and Wake Island, which are claimed by the United States under the Guano Islands Act of 1856. The status of some are disputed by Colombia, Haiti, Honduras, Jamaica, Nicaragua, and the Marshall Islands. The Palmyra Atoll is the only territory currently incorporated. Historically, territories were created to govern newly acquired land while the borders of the United States were still evolving. Most territories eventually attained statehood. Other territories administered by the United States went on to become independent countries, such as the Philippines, Micronesia, Marshall Islands and Palau. Micronesia, Marshall Islands and Palau gained independence under the Compact of Free Association, COFA, which allows the U.S. full authority over aid and defense in exchange for continued access to U.S. health care, government services such as the FCC and United States Postal Service, and the right for COFA citizens to work freely in the United States and vice versa. Many organized incorporated territories of the United States existed from 1789 to 1959, the first being the Northwest and the Southwest Territories, the last being the Alaska Territory and the Hawaii Territory, through which 31 territories applied for and were granted statehood. In the process of organizing and promoting territories to statehood, some areas of a territory demographically lacking sufficient development and population densities were temporarily orphaned from parts of a larger territory at the time a vote was taken. Petitioning Congress for statehood rights. For example, when a portion of the Missouri Territory became the state of Missouri, the remaining portion of the territory, consisting of the present states of Iowa, Nebraska and the Dakotas, most of Kansas, Wyoming, and Montana, and parts of Colorado and Minnesota, effectively became an unorganized territory. Contents 1. Current territories. 2. Incorporated and unincorporated territories. 21. Express or implied. 22. Incorporated territories. U.S. Supreme Court declarations. 221. Alaska Territory. 222. Florida Territory. 223. Southwest Territory. 224. Louisiana Territory. 3. Organized Territory. 4. Classification of current U.S. territories. 41. Incorporated organized territories. 42. Incorporated unorganized territories. 43. Unincorporated organized territories. 44. Unincorporated unorganized territories. 45. Extraterritorial jurisdiction. 46. Associated states. 5. Classification of former U.S. territories and administered areas. 51. Former incorporated organized territories of the United States. 52. Former unincorporated territories of the United States. Incomplete. 53. Former unincorporated territories of the United States under military government. 54. Areas formerly administered by the United States. 55. Other zones. 6. See also. 7. References. 8. External links. Current territories. Currently, the United States has 16 territories, 5 of which are permanently inhabited: Puerto Rico, Guam, Northern Mariana Islands, United States Virgin Islands and American Samoa. The 11 uninhabited territories administered by the Interior Department are Palmyra Atoll, Baker Island, Howland Island, Jarvis Island, Johnston Atoll, Kingman Reef, and Midway Islands, while claimed by the U.S., Navassa Island, Wake Island, Serenia Bank and Bajo Nuevo Bank are disputed territories have always been a part of the United States by Act of Congress. The term United States, when used in a geographical sense, means the continental United States, Alaska, Hawaii, Puerto Rico, Guam, and the Virgin Islands of the United States. Since political union with the Northern Mariana Islands in 1986, they too are treated as a part of the U.S. An executive order in 2007 includes American Samoa as U.S. geographical extent, duly reflected in U.S. State Department documents. Inhabited United States territories have democratic self-government, in local three-branch government. Governments, found respectively in Pago-Pago, American Samoa, Hagatnya, Territory of Guam, Saipan, Commonwealth of the Northern Mariana Islands, San Juan, Commonwealth of Puerto Rico, Charlotte Amalie, United States Virgin Islands. Approximately 4 million islanders are U.S. citizens. About 32,000 U.S. non-citizen nationals live in American Samoa under current law. Among the territories, only persons born in American Samoa and Swains Island are non-citizen U.S. nationals. American Samoans are under the protection of the U.S., with freedom of U.S. travel without visas. The five inhabited U.S. territories have local voting rights and protections under U.S. courts, pay some U.S. taxes, and have limited representation in the U.S. House of Representatives. They popularly elect members of Congress who, like the delegate from Washington, D.C., possess the same powers as other members of the House, except that they may not vote when the House is meeting as the House of Representatives. They participate in debate, are assigned offices and money for staff, and appoint constituents from their territories to the military viz, Army, Naval viz, Navy and Marine Corps, Air Force, Coast Guard, and Merchant Marine Service Academies. They can vote in committee on all legislation presented to the House of Representatives. They are included in their party count for each committee, and they are equal to senators on conference committees depending on the Congress. They may also vote on the floor in the House Committee of the Whole. Members of Congress from the territories seated as of January 2015 are Gregorio Sablin for the Northern Mariana Islands, Madeline Bordalo for Guam, Amada Coleman-Radwagon for American Samoa, Pedro Pierluisi for Puerto Rico, and Stacy Plaskett for the U.S. Virgin Islands. Every 4 years, the Democratic and Republican political parties nominate their presidential candidates at conventions, which include delegates from the five major territories. The citizens there, however, do not vote in the general election for U.S. President. Incorporated and unincorporated territories. Main article, Insular Cases. An incorporated territory of the United States is a specific area under the jurisdiction of the United States, over which the United States Congress has determined that the United States Constitution is to be applied to the territory's local government and inhabitants in its entirety, e.g., citizenship, trial by jury, in the same manner as it applies to the local governments and residents of the U.S. states. Incorporated territories are considered an integral part of the United States, as opposed to being merely possessions. All territory under the control of the federal government is considered part of the United States for purposes of law. From 1901 to 1905, the U.S. Supreme Court, in a series of opinions known as the Insular Cases, held that the Constitution extended ex proprio vigor by its own force to the territories. However, the court in these cases also established the doctrine of territorial incorporation, under which the Constitution applies fully only in incorporated territories such as the then Territory of Alaska and Territory of Hawaii, and applies only partially in the new unincorporated territories of Puerto Rico, Guam, and the Philippines. The U.S. had no unincorporated territories, also called overseas possessions or insular areas, until 1856. In that year, the U.S. Congress enacted the Guano Islands Act, which authorized the president to take possession of unclaimed islands for the purpose of mining guano. By virtue of this law, over the years the U.S. took control and claimed rights in respect of many islands, atolls, etc., especially in the Caribbean and the Pacific, most of which have since been abandoned. The U.S. has also acquired territories under other circumstances, such as under the Treaty of Paris that ended the Spanish-American War. The constitutional position of these unincorporated territories was considered by the Supreme Court in Balzac v. People of Puerto Rico, 258 U.S. 298-312-1922, where the court used, as an argument of non-incorporated territory, the following statement regarding the U.S. court in Puerto Rico: "The United States District Court is not a true United States court established under Article III of the Constitution to administer the judicial power of the United States therein conveyed. It is created by virtue of the sovereign congressional faculty, granted under Article 4, 3, of that instrument, of making all needful rules and regulations respecting the territory belonging to the United States the resemblance of its jurisdiction to that of true United States courts, in offering an opportunity to non-residents of resorting to a tribunal not subject to local influence, does not change its character as a mere territorial court in Glidden Co. v. Zadanek, 370 U.S. 530 1962. The court cited Balzac and made the following statement regarding courts in unincorporated territories. Upon like considerations, Article 3 has been viewed as inapplicable to courts created in unincorporated territories outside the mainland. Downs v. Bidwell, 182 U.S. 244, 266-267, Balzac v. Puerto Rico, 258 U.S. 298, 312-313, C.F. Dorr v. United States, 195 U.S. 138, 145,149, and to the consular courts established by concessions from foreign countries, in Ray Ross, 140 U.S. 453, 464-465, 488. The U.S. Supreme Court offers two ways in which incorporation could be made. Incorporation is not to be assumed without express declaration, or an implication so strong as to exclude any other view express or implied in Balzac, where Chief Justice Taft delivered the opinion of the court, the meaning of implied was specified. Had Congress intended to take the important step of changing the treaty status of Puerto Rico by incorporating it into the Union, it is reasonable to suppose that it would have done so by the plain declaration, and would not have left it to mere inference before the question became acute at the close of the Spanish War. The distinction between acquisition and incorporation was not regarded as important, or at least it was not fully understood and had not aroused great controversy before that. The purpose of Congress might well be a matter of mere inference from various legislative acts, but in these latter days, incorporation is not to be assumed without express declaration, or an implication so strong as to exclude any other view. Incorporated territories. U.S. Supreme Court declarations in Rasmussen v. U.S., 197 U.S. 516-1905, quoting from Article 3 of the 1867 Treaty for the Purchase of Alaska, the Supreme Court said, "The inhabitants of the ceded territory shall be admitted to the enjoyment of all the rights, advantages, and immunities of citizens of the United States." This declaration, although somewhat changed in phraseology, is the equivalent, as pointed out in Downs v. Bidwell, of the formula, employed from the beginning to express the purpose to incorporate acquired territory into the United States, especially in the absence of other provisions showing an intention to the contrary. Here we see that the act of incorporation is on the people of the territory, not on the territory per se. By extending the Privileges and Immunities Clause of the Constitution to them, the U.S. Supreme Court statements follow. Alaska Territory Congress Express Declaration, Rasmussen v. The United States, 197 U.S. 516, 522-1905, arose out of a misdemeanor conviction in Alaska by a jury composed of six persons pursuant to a federal statute allowing such a procedure in Alaska. In a decision written by Justice White, a majority of the court concluded that Alaska had been incorporated into the United States because the Treaty of Cession with Russia specifically declared that the inhabitants of the ceded territory shall be admitted to the enjoyment of all the rights, advantages, and immunities of citizens of the United States. In addition, there was congressional implication so strong as to exclude any other view, that Congress, shortly following the adoption of the treaty with Russia, clearly contemplated the incorporation of Alaska into the United States as a part thereof, we think plainly results from the Act of July 20, 1868, concerning internal revenue taxation, Chap. 186, 107 15 Stat at L. 167, U.S. Comp. Stat 1901, p. 2277, and the Act of July 27, 1868, Chap. 273, extending the laws of the United States relating to customs, commerce, and navigation over Alaska, and establishing a collection district therein 15 Stat at L. 240, and this is fortified by subsequent action of Congress, which it is unnecessary to refer to. Rasmussen at 533-534. Justice Brown, in his concurring opinion, also expressed the same thought. Apparently, acceptance of the territory is insufficient in the opinion of the court in this case, since the result that Alaska is incorporated into the United States is reached, not through the treaty with Russia, or through the establishment of a civil government there, but from the Act of July 20, 1868, concerning internal revenue taxation, and the Act of July 27, 1868, extending the laws of the United States relating to the customs, commerce, and navigation over Alaska, and establishing a collection district there. Certain other acts are cited, notably the Judiciary Act of March 3, 1891, making it the duty of this court to assign 197 U.S. 516, 534 the several territories of the United States to particular circuits. Florida Territory in Dorr v. USA 195 U.S. 138, 141, 142, 1904. Justice Marshall is quoted more extensively as follows. The sixth article of the Treaty of Session contains the following provision: the inhabitants of the territories which His Catholic Majesty cedes the United States by this treaty shall be incorporated in the Union of the United States as soon as may be consistent with the principles of the Federal Constitution, and admitted to the enjoyment of the privileges, rights, and immunities of the citizens of the United States. This treaty is the law of the land, and admits the inhabitants of Florida to the enjoyment of the privileges, rights, and immunities of the citizens of the United States. It is unnecessary to inquire whether this is not their condition. Independent of stipulation, they do not, however, participate in political power. They do not share in the government till Florida shall become a state. In the meantime, Florida continues to be a territory of the United States, governed by virtue of that clause in the Constitution which empowers Congress to make all needful rules and regulations respecting the territory or other property belonging to the United States. In Downs v. Bidwell, 182 U.S. 244, 56-1901, Justice Brown says, the same construction was adhered to in the treaty with Spain for the purchase of Florida 8 Stat at L. 252, the sixth article of which provided that the inhabitants should be incorporated into the Union of the United States, as soon as may be consistent with the principles of the Federal Constitution. Southwest Territory in Downs v. Bidwell Supra at 321-322, the first mention of incorporation is made in the following paragraph by Justice Brown: in view of this it cannot, it seems to me, be doubted that the United States continued to be composed of states and territories, all forming an integral part thereof and incorporated therein, as was the case prior to the adoption of the Constitution. Subsequently, the territory now embraced in the state of Tennessee was ceded to the United States by the state of North Carolina in order to ensure the rights of the native inhabitants. It was expressly stipulated that the inhabitants of the ceded territory should enjoy all the rights, privileges, benefits, and advantages set forth in the ordinance of the late Congress for the government of the Western Territory of the United States. Louisiana Territory, first U.S. stamp to commemorate a territory and depict a map, 1904. In Downs v. Bidwell Supra at 252, it was said, owing to a new war between England and France being upon the point of breaking out, there was need for haste in the negotiations, and Mr. Livingston took the responsibility of disobeying his Mr. Jefferson's instructions, and, probably owing to the insistence of Bonaparte, consented to the 3D article of the treaty with France to acquire the territory of Louisiana, which provided that the inhabitants of the ceded territory shall be incorporated in the Union of the United States, and admitted as soon as possible, according to the principles of the Federal Constitution, to the enjoyment of all the rights, advantages, and immunities of citizens of the United States, and in the meantime they shall be maintained and protected in the free enjoyment of their liberty, property, and the religion which they profess. This evidently committed the government to the ultimate, but not to the immediate, admission of Louisiana as a state. The Supreme Court of the United States is unanimous in its interpretation that the extension of the Privileges and Immunities Clause of the Constitution of the United States to the inhabitants of a territory in effect produces the incorporation of that territory. The net effect of incorporation is that the territory becomes an integral part of the geographical boundaries of the United States and cannot, from then on, be separated. Indeed, the whole body of the U.S. Constitution is extended to the inhabitants of that territory, except for those provisions that relate to its federal character. More so, the needful rules and regulations of the territorial clause must yield to the Constitution and the inherent constraints imposed on it in dealing with the privileges and immunities of the inhabitants of the incorporated territory. Notice must be taken that Incorporation of a territory takes place through the incorporation of its inhabitants, not of the territory per se as such. Those inhabitants receive the full impact of the U.S. Constitution, except for those provisions that deal specifically with the federal character of the Union in the contemporary sense. The term unincorporated territory refers primarily to insular areas. There is currently only one incorporated territory, Palmyra Atoll, which is not an organized territory. Conversely, a territory can be organized without being an incorporated territory, a contemporary example being Puerto Rico. See Organized Incorporated Territories of the United States and Unincorporated Territories of the United States for timelines. Organized territory lands under the sovereignty of the federal government but not part of any state that were given a measure of self-rule by the Congress through an organic act subject to the Congress's plenary powers under the Territorial Clause of Article 4, Sec 3, of the U.S. Constitution. Classification of current U.S. territories. See also, Insular Area and List of U.S. Colonial Possessions. Incorporated Organized Territories. Main Article, Organized Incorporated Territories of the United States. No incorporated organized territories have existed since 1959, the last two being the Territory of Hawaii and Territory of Alaska, both of which achieved statehood in that year, with their representative stars being added in the Blue Field, Canton of the American flag on Independence Day, July 4, in 1959 and 1960, respectively. Incorporated unorganized territories. Many incorporated unorganized territories became incorporated organized territories or states. For example, when the eastern part of the incorporated organized territory called Minnesota became the state of Minnesota in 1858, the western part became part of an unorganized territory later that became a part of the Dakota Territory, out of which two states and some parts of other states were created. California was part of an unorganized territory when it became a state. Name, location, area, population, capital. Note: Palmyra Atoll, Polynesia. Unincorporated Organized Territories. Main Article, Unincorporated Territories of the United States. Name, Location, Area, Population, Capital. Note: Saipan Commonwealth since 1978, formerly a United Nations Trust Territory under the administration of the U.S. 106,405. Charlotte Amalie, purchased by the U.S. from Denmark in 1917. Polynesia, 1936, and placed under the jurisdiction of the United States Department of the Interior. Jarvis Island, Polynesia, claimed under the Guano Islands Act on February 8, 1860, formally annexed on May 10, 1922, and placed under the jurisdiction of the United States Department of the Navy on December 29, 1934. Zero territory since 1857, claimed by Haiti. Serenia Bank, Caribbean. Monument. Extraterritorial jurisdiction. The United States exercises some degree of extraterritorial jurisdiction in overseas areas such as Guantanamo Bay Naval Base since 1903, a 45. Of this group, are retained by the U.S. Quita Sueño Bank 1869-1981, claimed under Guano Islands Act. Claim abandoned on September 7, 1981, by Treaty. Roncador Bank 1856-1981, claimed under Guano Islands Act. Ceded to Colombia on September 7, 1981, by Treaty. Sarana Bank 1874-1981, claimed under Guano Islands Act. Ceded to Colombia on September 7, 1981, by Treaty. Swan Islands 1863-1972, claimed under Guano Islands Act. Ceded to Honduras in 1972, by treaty. Former unincorporated territories of the United States under military government. Japan by mutual agreement. Occupation of Japan 1945-1952. After World War II, U.S. participation in the occupation of the Rhineland. Germany 1918-1921. South Korea. U.S. occupation of the south of the 38th parallel north in Korea in 1945-1948. The region is slightly different from the current practical boundary of the Republic of Korea. South Korea since the ceasefire of the Korean War. See also Division of Korea. Coalition. Provisional Authority. Iraq 2003-2004. Green Zone. Iraq March 20, 2003 to December 31, 2008. Clipperton Island 1944-1945, occupied territory, returned to France on October 23, 1945. Grenada Invasion and Occupation 1983. See also List of U.S. Colonial Possessions. Political Divisions of the United States. Historic Regions of the United States. Organized Incorporated Territories of the United States. Unincorporated Territories of the United States. Organic Acts of 1845-46. Enabling Act. United States. Hawaiian Organic Act Territorial Clause Insular Cases Political Status of Puerto Rico Extreme Points of the United States Territories of the United States on Stamps United States Minor Outlying Islands Unorganized Territories United States Territory References Carat Definition of Terms 1120 Acquisition of U.S. Nationality and U.S. Territories and Possessions PDF U.S. Department of State Foreign Affairs Manual Volume 7 Consular Affairs U.S. Department of State America, Report to the UN Committee on Human Rights, December 30, 2011, Sec. 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, viewed September 3, 2015 American Samoa, Guam and U.S. Virgin Islands appear on the UN Non-Self-Governing Territories List, viewed September 3, 2015 Carat U.S. General Accounting Office Report, U.S. Insular Areas, Application of the U.S. Constitution, November 1997, P1, 6, 39 N viewed April 6, 2016 Carat U.S. State Department, Dependencies and Areas of Special Sovereignty Chart, under Sovereignty, lists 9 places under United States sovereignty administered by the Interior Department in Washington, D.C., Baker Island, Howland Island, Jarvis Island, Johnston Atoll, Kingman Reef, Midway Islands, Navassa Island, Palmyra Atoll, and Wake Island Carat Sparrow, Bartholomew H., in Levinson, S. and Sparrow, B.H., the Louisiana Purchase and American Expansion, 1-803-1898-2005-ISBN-0-7425-4984-4 p. 232 viewed December 2, 2012. At present, the United States includes the Caribbean and Pacific territories, the District of Columbia and, of course, the 50 states Carat AB 7 FAM 1112 State Department Foreign Affairs Manual FAM 7 Consular Affairs viewed January 12, 2016 Carat Executive Order 13423 Sec 9L The United States, when used in a geographical sense, means the 50 states, the District of Columbia, the Commonwealth of Puerto Rico, Guam, American Samoa, the U.S. Virgin Islands, and the Northern Mariana Islands, and associated territorial waters and airspace. Carat U.S. State Department, Dependencies and Areas of Special Sovereignty Chart, under Sovereignty, lists 5 places under United States sovereignty administered by a local administrative center, with short form names, American Samoa, Guam, Northern Mariana Islands, Puerto Rico, Virgin Islands, U.S. Carat Nativity by Place of Birth and Citizenship Status, United States Census, 2010 Carat AB 7 FAM 1111B State Department Foreign Affairs Manual FAM 7 Consular Affairs However, as reported in Samoa Lawsuit, Newsweek, July 13, 2012 viewed December 16, 2012 Certain native Samoan objections arise opposing U.S. citizenship at birth as meaning all of the U.S. Constitution applies everywhere in American Samoa that would prevent certain communal land ownership rules in American Samoa favoring those with Samoan blood Carat House Learn webpage viewed January 26, 2013 Carat House Learn webpage viewed January 26, 2013 Carat Application of the U.S. Constitution, GAO Report, U.S. Insular Areas, November 1997, p. 26-28. Carat viewed August 10, 2015 Carat The Green Papers, 2016 Presidential Primaries, Caucuses and Conventions, viewed September 3, 2015 Carat Definitions of Insular Area Political Organizations, Office of Insular Affairs, U.S. Department of the Interior, retrieved 14 November 2007. 3. Congressional incorporation of Puerto Rico throughout the past century has extended the entire constitution to the island. Carat Hun Gustavo A. Gelpi, The Insular Cases, A Comparative Historical Study of Puerto Rico, Hawaii, and the Philippines, The Federal Lawyer, March, April 2011 http://vwaspro.org/files/legal_opinion_on_pr_insular_cassespdf p25, in light of the ruling in Bumadine, in the future the Supreme Court will be called upon to re-examine the insular cases doctrine as applied to Puerto Rico and other U.S. territories. Carat accessed 26 January 2013. Puerto Rico is a self-governing, unincorporated territory of the United States located in the Caribbean. Carat IBP USA 2009, Samoa American Country Study Guide, Strategic Information and Developments, International Business Publications, pp. Writings of jurists and especially in documents, published and unpublished, issued by presidents and secretaries of state of the United States, the opinions of the attorneys general, and the decisions of courts, federal and state Washington, D.C., U.S. Government Printing Office pp. Carrot Michael Ratner, Ellen Ray 2004 Guantanamo, What the World Should Know Chelsea Green Publishing p. Law to Unorganized Unincorporated Territories Television Stations in U.S. Territories Unincorporated Territory Office of Insular Affairs Application of the U.S. Constitution in U.S. Insular Areas Department of the Interior Definitions of Insular Area Political Organizations United States District Court Decision Addressing the Distinction Between Incorporated versus Unincorporated Territories v. Political Divisions of the United States States Alabama Alaska Arizona Arkansas California Colorado